broadcast live.
Yo, Slick on Life, salute us, man. YoungstaCPT, YoungstaCaps, that representing for the one and only Western Cape. Slick on Life, always hooking the Owens up, always looking out for us, always staying up to date on what's going on the ground.
Young star, Lou. When I was 8, I tried my first pair of Jordans on. Asked my mom, can we buy these? She said, sorry son, I just can't afford, so I...
Yeah, so the names of the two projects were mixtapes number 28 and 29. Now the first one is called Capsta Sleeping. I even got a customized cap to go with Dave from Flexfit. Need to salute him for that one. And the second one is called How to Make It in South Africa. Even got customized cap for that one as well. So the first one, Capsta's Revenge, fully produced by Jay Beats. Now, for those of you who have been following me, you know, before the last 2 years or 3 years, the track Salutas was produced by Jay Beats. The track Ella was produced by Jay Beats. The Aware 4 Corners joint that appeared on the soundtrack of 4 Corners was produced by Jay Beats. Most of the freestyle mixtape, which was my 24th, or 21st, no, that's the 21st mixtape, most of the freestyle was produced by Jay Beats as well. And then, when I moved to Johannesburg in 2015, I befriended a young man who lived opposite me by the name of Loops. I discovered he had a studio. I discovered he was a dope producer, hidden gem. I mean, he worked with a lot of guys, EJ, who came up in the game with Tweezy, them when they were doing the Ghetto Prophecy thing. Worked with MT as well when he was still like hustling in Hillbro and shit like that, you know. So they go way back, you know. So I befriended this man, being that I lived across the road from him when I moved to Joburg. And we came up with the whole project, you know, which usually happens when people in the studio for too long. And it's opposite my house. Convenient, you know, you can go have supper and then go record a track. It's a beautiful life, you know.
I pulled out the stock kamikaze Reeboks, but when I was 8, I tried my first pair of Jordans.
I just felt that it also gives two different perspectives of South Africa, you know. One is Capsta, one is South Africa. And when I think of South Africa, I think of Joburg as the hub of it. You know, Joburg is where all the information comes from, where the head offices and the entertainment industry is based, I would say, you know. So, I mean, How to Make It in South Africa is also derived from the TV series How to Make It in America, you know, of two guys who want to start up a clothing label, but then they discover, like, it's not that easy. And I just feel like, I mean, two guys who want to be hip-hop stars, it's not that easy either, you know. So, this was the story that we had to tell, and this is what documented, this is what came out. And then Capsta's Revenge, I mean, from track one, from the opening track, you are going to hear that it's Cape Town. You are not going to think it's anything else. It's not going to sound like a different region. It will strictly be Cape Townian from track one. As soon as you put it in, you're like, okay, I'm in Cape Town now. I can feel it, you know. And How to Make It in South Africa has more or less a South African feel. Like anybody, anywhere, any region that you come from, if you listen to this tape, you will definitely understand it from track one. I don't make it too intricate or specific to my demographic that I'm speaking to. It's not just colored people who can enjoy this or this necessarily, you know. But, I mean, it's two totally different projects, but it's the same guy.
The sneaker exchange, and I see the other rappers have been peeping the game. Oh shit, I see you hype beasting again. You a sneaker head, so is it life or death?
But I mean, this house here, level 4, is where we recorded this tape. It wasn't mixed and mastered there, because this is a trap. There's no mixing and mastering taking place in the trap, my man. But the recordings were all done in here, so this is grimy, this is straight up G ghetto shit, you know what I mean? This is what hip hop is supposed to sound like these days. Even though it's a new age sound and it has the trap element in it still, I mean, what we're talking about is real trap, like what it's like to live in the trap, you know? I lived opposite this flat. So I mean, it encompasses a time in my life when I was also on the grind. 2015, 2 short years ago, man. But that's kind of when things also took off for me, when I started coming to Joburg a lot and living there, you know. And then the Capsta's Revenge one, this cover is done at Cape Audio, which is actually where I recorded all the songs on here as well. So all the tracks were recorded at Cape Audio Studios, and then mixed by Cape Faith, mixed and mastered by Cape Faith, both these projects. And she's a girl, female, strong woman, and she engineered both these projects. So I mean, at the same time, we're also promoting like up and coming creatives who are not only rappers or producers. I mean, as an engineer also, for you to be a part of two projects like this, and I mean the whole rollout, I mean doing physical copies, your work lives, you know. It's not just on the internet, your work is alive, you know? So big ups to everybody who was involved in the project, YTN for life.
Broadcast live.